What up to, we're going to talk about once again, a household is much, much different than being raised a single father versus a single mother. Period, point blank. No second guessing whether feelings have been so valid. Don't doubt it. Apparently, Charlie Sheen's daughter was trying to friends. Of course, she's 18 years of age, 18 years old right now. So, in theory, she has more power over where she wants to live and decisions and stuff like that. Well, one thing that got my attention is when Charlie Sheen was basically like, well, it didn't happen under my roof. And that's how men are. Super fathers. Certain levels of nonsense we are not going to tolerate. Period. Point blank, period. The article basically says Charlie Sheen reacts to daughter Sammy Sheen, 18, joining OnlyFans. This comment was basically, this did not occur under my roof. Of course it did. Because the mother, Denise Richards, probably, she's probably one of those mothers that would rather be a child's best friend, so that's the parent. This is probably some things that took place like over the years, long periods of time, things that they had that he had to put up with and deal with the switches. Oh, baby mama drama. Oh yes. It happens all the time. Nobody is escaping the sword. The sword is for everybody. Don't matter what race you are. Will be called out. Period. Point blank. Period. Motherfuckers. Check it out. Basically, Denise Richards and Charlie Sheen's eldest daughter, Sammy Sheen, is joining us. She is 18 years old now, living with her mother, former 2.5. Star told Fox News Digital on Tuesday via his publicist, Jeff Ballard. This did not occur under my roof. I do not condone this, but since I'm unable to prevent it, I urge her to keep it classy, creative, and not sacrifice her integrity. Oh, the sacrificial lamb of integrity has already been laid on the plate and chopped up. You can get that once they go to OnlyFans. That integrity is on top of the window. A lot of these chicks are over there, and they know whether to get a nice, big, fat tip, they gotta do a little extra with some strange or change. Gotta reveal or else those simps just flooding OnlyFans that keep OnlyFans afloat and relevant. They would start in his pocket, especially now we look at society where we deal with gas prices. Before you heard it, we would be $8, $9, $10. You know, some parts of the country are still about that. So what's going to happen? All of a sudden, thirsty sense that people are only fans. They don't stop. As a matter of fact, they're going to stop eating tips at all. These girls are going to realize, oh shit, I got to do something extra. That's what classic, the whole keep it classic thing. Hey, sorry, Charlie, that ain't going to fly. She's really trying to use OnlyFans as a way to earn a living. Good
open up to that. So I'm gonna let me open up that. That shit can fly right there. But like you said, it didn't occur in my view. I find it ironic, seems like she, the daughter, Sammy, knew she couldn't get away with certain things on her dad's room. So conveniently, she decides to relocate under her mother's lease. And it wasn't by accident. It's not strategic. It's not anything. There's no mystery to it. There's no why you relocate under your mom's room. Because you might be getting away with things like this. Even at 18 years old, I'm going to bet. Even Sandy would probably do this. If she's to stay under her dad's roof, she wouldn't be able to shit like this. That's probably that's the main reason why Charlie said what he said. Now, who knows what went on through the years? The relationship, I'm not like real familiar with their interactions over the years. Like how messy it was. Was the alimony involved? Child support? I'm not familiar with any of that. Maybe y'all can share that with me. Some stories that might slip past me. But they were only married from 2002 to 2006. So, but within that time, raising a daughter within that time, there's no telling what kind of manipulative tactics the child you have to put up with, especially when he was dealing with his own personal demons throughout the years. So I'm sure that didn't help. And if you got a baby mama who's already against you and pulling at the opposite end of the rope, that makes it even worse. But for him to come out and be like, yo, that didn't happen under my roof, wouldn't happen under my roof. Since she's not under my roof anymore, there's nothing I can really do about it. It's kind of sad. The whole situation is sad. I mean, as a father, you don't want your daughter. First of all, even if she was the classical, like, stripper, whatever, no father wants their daughter, strippers, pole, stripper, doing that for them, taking off their clothes, wearing all kind of degrading, nasty, debauchery shit for a couple dollars. So that's, to me, that's probably the first correlation that popped in his head when he found out she was going to start the OnlyFans. That's part of the first initial reaction. As a father, right? She didn't see her daughter doing that. But she fled to be under her mother's roof because apparently it seems like she can get away with stuff like that over there. You know? That's just my personal opinion. Allegedly, other than what has been said in this article. And I'm going to leave a link to this article in the description box down below. Y'all let me know what y'all think. Yeah, she's 18 now, so hey, it is what it is, Chuck. Pretty much going to have to let that ride. But it's just a reflection of how households are run. Versus a single father in a household raising kids. The discipline and direction, straightforwardness that you get under that roof versus a single mother versus willy nilly and everything's fine. And you'll see down the line how those children pan out in the game of life. But, yo, that's all I got for now. Y'all let me know what y'all think. Like, share, and subscribe. Red Blizzard out the door.